As the 20th century ended, the Voyager 1 probe became the furthest distant human-made object from Earth. Clearly, we are heading into uncharted territory. The first to reach interstellar space was our technological spacecraft Ambassador. The scenario marked the end of a tale involving the four most distant planets in the solar system, known as the icy worlds. Nonetheless, it reached a new milestone after more than 15 years. In 1977, the twin Voyager probes departed to investigate the gas giants Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. What was their origin? Their formation fascinates us. Some of the detected objects on Voyager's journey were so unexpected that they were not considered during the design of the spacecraft. These expeditions paved the way for a new era in robotics research. We must return, since there were so many unanswered questions. A few distant moons may have the greatest conceivable life beyond Earth. Enceladus is the most probable contender for life in our solar system. We also search our systems and outermost regions for a new, unidentified planet. Planet 9 still needs to be identified, providing it exists. We are using a needle to find a needle in a haystack during the early phases of the development of our solar system. Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune are newly formed giant planets. There, where a newly formed sun's radiation was strong enough to expel light gases and destroy all eyes, rocky planets form, but at a safe distance. This area consisted of ice, water, methane, hydrogen, and helium. During the early history of the solar system, the planets exerted gravity. These giants of gas ingested all the gas. Human curiosity has been stretched to these distant planets. Before Voyager, we investigated the solar system's innermost worlds. We traveled to Venus, Mercury, and Mars. However, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune are well-known planets to the scientific community. To reach the giants, one must journey 160 million kilometers beyond the Earth's orbit, via a protoplanet graveyard, an asteroid belt, and remnants of the solar system's genesis. And we had only elementary telescopic observations of some of these things. We were required to transit across the asteroid belt separating Mars and Jupiter. Will we, as humans, ever go across that area of space? Pioneer 10 was the first spacecraft to reach the asteroid belt in 1972. In the popular imagination, the asteroid belt is an area of space debris comprised of slow-moving, mountain-sized asteroids. The opposite could not be farther from the truth. According to scientists, there is a 1 in 10 possibility of a violent collision with spacecraft transiting this region. Even though there are many rocks, they are uniformly scattered in a vast ring or space area. However, collisions occur less often than you may believe. Pioneer was victorious after 7 months of this asteroid combat. When a spacecraft like the Pioneer stretched its reach outside the solar system, we reached another critical milestone in our cosmic exploration. By the end of the year, the probe had successfully crossed Jupiter and was employing its gravity to exit the solar system. Until 1998, Pioneer 10 was our most distant spacecraft. Before Pioneer 10, the most exciting characteristics of our solar system were inaccessible. NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory discovered an alignment of the outer planets in the 1960s. Utilizing its combined gravity, a spaceship may swing from one planet to the next while consuming minimum fuel. Voyager was a milestone event in the history of space exploration. A great trip that included interactions with several planets was deemed credible. The alignment would only occur again for 2 centuries if NASA had taken advantage of the opportunity. For Voyager 1 and 2, they constructed identical sensors. Together, they would allow unequaled access to the solar system's farthest regions. Let's examine these metrics in detail. The Voyager spacecraft is an archaic object today by our modern standards. We would never have seen such detailed photographs of such distant bodies. The harsh atmosphere of space would put 1970s technology to the test for decades. They were equipped with obsolete television cameras that may be found in a 1970s television studio. In their recording setups, they used 8-track cassettes. Nonetheless, the equipment gathered vital information on the mission's objectives. Modern spacecraft that venture to other planets are crewless. They are well-made and somewhat intelligent robots. Each Voyager probe brought greetings from humans. Carl Sagan, a renowned scientist, astronomer, and communicator, decided to include a cultural item in the scientific journey of two explorers. This was the situation with the famous Golden Record. He conveyed greetings throughout the universe on behalf of the inhabitants of our planet, hoping to foster peace and harmony. Theoretically, it is intended for any alien species that could encounter them. It signifies to humans that we intend to transmit something unique from Earth into space. If extraterrestrial species can comprehend the disc's instructions, it includes 115 pictures, 90 minutes of music, and 55 languages of greetings. Voyager 2 was launched for the first time on August 20, 1977. After 2 weeks, Voyager 1 initiated its journey. After 2 years, each participant arrived at the first symbolic stop of their epic journey among the gas giants. Jupiter is twice as massive as the other planets in our solar system. All these little mass globules collided to form Jupiter during the early stages of the solar system formation. The newborn planet developed bulk by consuming asteroids and comets in its vicinity. It was finally able to capture gases once it cooled. As a result, it has an athletic center and a great deal of gas. Jupiter is indeed the most powerful planet. Pioneer 10 provided the first close-up view of Jupiter, but the Voyagers would reveal far more of the planet's mysteries. We were aware of the situation. As Voyager neared, a highly detailed scene was viewed. More weather patterns resembling Earth were seen. One of the most critical challenges was investigating Jupiter's enormous red spot. Jupiter's immensity is one of the most effective reminders of our insignificance. It is enormous and reminiscent of a tropical hurricane. It was discovered for the first time about 400 years ago. It is intriguing, but more comprehension was required. In the 19th century, the enormous red stain on Jupiter spanned three Earths, but it was just the size of two when the Voyagers arrived. While the massive cyclone on Jupiter had been known for some time, Voyager 1 discovered a brand new feature: faint Saturn-like rings that had never been observed before. The rings are believed to have been generated by the moons of Jupiter dumping material into their parents' orbit. Future research might uncover rings around each gas giant in our solar system. Saturn changed from being the only ringed planet in the solar system to become one of several. Additionally, the Voyagers explored several of Jupiter's naturally occurring satellites. Galileo's discovery of Jupiter's four enormous moons profoundly affected how people saw the solar system, making the discovery of Jupiter's moons a significant event in human history. The revelation made by Galileo in 1610 led to the death of the geocentric theory of the universe. All the planets, including Earth and its satellites, orbit around the Sun. Io, the innermost moon of the Galilean system, is an unstable region with up to 400 volcanoes. Every second, the volcanoes produce tons of sulfur dioxide. As seen by the Voyager spacecraft, the moon's tight elliptical orbit around such a massive planet caused its surface to be covered with lava and sulfur. Typically, a moon would not have such an active core, but Jupiter is causing this to occur. Jupiter's uneven gravitational pull creates tidal forces generated by rocks. The surface may inflate and deflate by up to 100 meters every cycle, and frictional forces help keep the inside heated and the rock under the surface fluid. Europa, the most intriguing of the Galilean moons, is the smallest. Due to its extreme interior pressures and temperatures, it is the body in the solar system with the most excellent level of volcanic activity. According to researchers, Europa has more water than the oceans. The sea is churning. The dense ice cover of Europa covers liquid oceans. Convective currents pouring to the surface and ice fractures are examples of how the ocean's currents manifest their influence. Additionally, life may exist anywhere there is water. We are now discussing the validity of Europa as a planet-like body. The Earth has liquid water, an abundant energy source, and organic chemistry. In less than a billion years, life sprang from the same ingredients. Jupiter and its moons could only be studied more deeply in the last decades of the 20th century. In 1989, the Galileo spacecraft was released from the shuttle Atlantis. The spacecraft was in the limelight in 1994 when the comet Shoemaker-Levy 9 was blasted apart by Jupiter's immense gravity. The travel to Jupiter, however, would take 6 years, so Galileo saw an extraterrestrial impact while traveling to Jupiter. Due to the interaction of celestial mechanics, we saw one of the solar system's most stunning phenomena. Many individuals believed that Jupiter's clouds would absorb the fragments. However, more energy than Earth's nuclear arsenal was released when each component entered the atmosphere. Galileo discovered the most significant impact crater, hundreds of kilometers wide. The collision of Shoemaker-Levy 9 illustrated how the gravitational pull of Jupiter affects our planet. Like the other planets, Jupiter is a gravitational bully that has altered the course of human history. It has likely protected us from asteroid and comet collisions, which would explain the origin of life on Earth. Jupiter's gravity attracts these objects. Within the scope of the Galileo mission, two explorers visited Jupiter. All of them came in December of 1995. The main spacecraft was accompanied by a smaller probe on its route to a short but crucial encounter with the planet's atmosphere. They hoped the Galileo probe might penetrate the atmosphere and descend to the planet's surface in search of water. However, when Galileo approached orbit, it descended below the cloud tops of Jupiter. The probe descended rapidly, reaching a depth of 180 kilometers, a record. Did the clouds of Jupiter create rain? What was the weather like? What was the stress level? Was there lightning in the vicinity? All these occurrences were uncovered along the road, validating our assumptions about this dynamic environment for the first time. In 2003, after completing its 35th orbit, Galileo entered Jupiter's atmosphere. The same outcome. As soon as the signal disappeared, the probe was destroyed. Following the launch, the ship was sanitized. The voyage may have contaminated Jupiter's moons, but the devastation has ensured that no life has survived. In the next 13 years, Jupiter was only seen from a distance. In 2016, the solar-powered spacecraft Juno arrived and entered a polar orbit. Instead of observing Jupiter's clouds, the Juno mission was designed to investigate the planet's internal processes. How do gas giant planets such as Jupiter form? We are still learning how such large universes are constructed. Every one of its very eccentric orbits. Jupiter was crossed by Juno with around 8,000 kilometers to spare. This corresponds to bouncing a basketball 1 millimeter off the ground. However, we are moving at tens of thousands of kilometers per hour. we could fully appreciate what was beyond the clouds because of Juno. Jupiter's rocky core creates a powerful magnetic field. The magnetic field of the Earth is 20,000 times less potent. Do you know that it was constructed with sufficient shielding to avoid similar attempts from frying its electrical components? Inside Jupiter, it is no longer considered a gas giant. When liquid hydrogen is compressed, it acquires metallic characteristics. Due to Juno, we now have a comprehensive understanding of its structure. Saturn is a ringed planet. This second largest planet in our solar system was named after the Roman god of agriculture. Since ancient times, Saturn has been visible in the night sky, and its rings were discovered shortly after the construction of the first telescopes. Both voyagers arrived at their next destination as the 1980s began. When Galileo pointed his telescope at Saturn, he was confused. Nobody in history understood that planets could possess rings. He attempted to characterize Saturn by asserting that it looked to possess it. In 1659, Dutch astronomer Christian Huygens used a more powerful telescope of his own design to determine that Galileo's ears were a series of rings. Each Voyager spacecraft landed at Saturn around 1 month apart. The Voyagers provided an abundance of information on Saturn. They found rings that had never been observed on Earth before. Rings are around 10 meters thick and 200 million kilometers wide. The final day's stunning images from the Voyager 2 spacecraft revealed a great deal about Saturn and its rings and moons. Dust, ranging in size from grains to rocks the size of mountains, orbits the Earth at 80,000 kilometers per hour, kept in place above and below the rings by a peculiar magnetic field. They could disassemble the rings into their constituent rock and ice. A new Voyager study has offered insight into the mysterious origins of the rings. Long ago, the origin of Saturn's rings was shrouded in mystery. Were they generated by Saturn's immense gravity? Or did they develop later owing to the destruction of a more petite errant body? It may have happened recently when an ice moon approached the Earth too closely and shattered into rings. In 1655, Christian Huygens found Titan, the giant moon of Saturn. Italian-French astronomer Jean-Dominique Cassini found four more. NASA, ESA, the Italian Space Agency, and the Joint Exploration Project were launched in 1997 and named after both men. The Voyager probes were a key impetus for the Cassini-Huygens missions because of the enthralling observations made near Saturn. Like the NASA-sponsored Cassini mission, the Huygens mission originated in Europe. The mission included two separate spacecraft. These two teams, originating on different sides of the Atlantic, might accomplish more than any other project. Cassini and Huygens must rate among the glories of the outer solar system exploration. Our comprehension of Saturn, a gorgeous planet with rings, its atmosphere, and several fascinating moons, has expanded significantly after 13 years of beautiful discoveries. A significant endeavor. Some observed objects were so unexpected that they were not accounted for in the design of the mission. After a seven-year trip, Cassini-Huygens landed on Saturn. Initial objectives included circumnavigating the world. By traveling through them, Cassini revealed unparalleled information about Saturn's rings. Each pass was fraught with apprehension. Mission control had to maneuver the spacecraft carefully through the debris field. What obstacles will it face as it progresses around the ring? What impact will it have on the system's electronics? If the spaceship collides with particles or tiny objects, will it be destroyed? This involves a substantial amount of work. Novel use of orbital mechanics. Rain falls onto the planet's surface from the rings. we saw water evaporating from the ring at around 40 tons per second. Cassini saw Saturn's first hurricane-like formation and a hexagonal atmospheric structure near the North Pole. The formation of the hexagonal structure at Saturn's North Pole was caused by a storm almost 50 times more potent than any hurricane on Earth. The Cassini spacecraft captured images of Saturn and its whole ring system during a solar eclipse on July 19, 2013. The Sun was aligned behind Saturn in one of the most breathtaking views from the far side. The approximately 650,000-kilometer-long image shows Saturn's second outermost ring made of minuscule ice particles. The image also depicts a sliver of light from Earth, located around 1 trillion 400 million kilometers distant. Again, we never anticipated that these gas giants would have similar weather systems to ours. Since photons from Earth's surface would be detected by the Cassini spacecraft and included in the image, the ESA recommended that everyone go outdoors and gaze up at the sky on that day and time. Cassini photographed multiple Saturnian moons throughout its mission, but just one captured its attention. Enceladus is the sixth largest moon of Saturn. Under the ice, kilometers above its characteristic southern stripes, lies a saltwater ocean. The Cassini spacecraft discovered ice fractures and water geysers erupting from an oceanic depth. Due to these volcanic outbursts that propel debris into space, it is possible to explore this ocean without setting foot on the moon. The geyser is anticipated to erupt. As she sailed above the geysers, Cassini found that the water was warmer than she had anticipated. It hypothesized that heat vents may exist at the ocean's bottom, where life may flourish. In addition, both fundamental and advanced organic chemistry are covered. Enceladus would be the most probable contender for life in our solar system. If we can visit Enceladus in the future and install underwater drones to examine what lies underneath, it will be a turning point in our knowledge of whether life exists elsewhere in the solar system. Either life is present daily, or its necessities are typical, and it is anticipated that it exists in this secluded, frigid zone encircling Saturn. Years before Cassini, Voyager 1's short encounter with Saturn's giant moon Titan sparked our curiosity, with no doubt. The photographs we received this morning portray a unique universe. It was enticing. We gained new knowledge, but were left with many unanswered questions that we needed to return. Titan's mysteries were concealed by its dense atmosphere. Hydrocarbons, mostly ethane and methane, combine with sunlight to form a hazy atmosphere in Titan's atmosphere. It is cloudy because other, more populous regions are also affected by pollution haze. On December 25, 2004, Huygens was launched from Cassini and started its 22-day trip to its destination. As part of the Cassini mission, the European Space Agency launched a Titan landing probe. It landed safely and without incident on Earth, and returned an abundance of data. Huygens, the first spacecraft to land on a solar system object, continued to send data for 72 minutes until its batteries ran out. Huygens plummeted for 2.5 hours after landing, and it revealed to us a world covered in ice, mountains, sand dunes, and features resembling rivers, although these features were caused by organic molecules of ethane and methane precipitating from its clouds and flowing across a surface covered in water ice and into large lakes, rather than by liquid water flowing across the surface. It was almost primitive. It depicted what we believed the Earth looked like 3 billion years ago, just as life began to flourish. In addition, life may have grown or developed on Titan if it did so in comparable circumstances on Earth. It is possible that something exists, even if it is not life as we know it. Because of the complexity of chemistry, life may arise. Another concern is whether we would be able to notice it if it occurred. After 294 orbits of Saturn and 20 years in space, the Cassini spacecraft ran out of fuel. A trip between Saturn's atmosphere and its rings was another first for the expedition that was fraught with peril. Cassini was repeatedly maneuvered through a minuscule breach in Saturn's rings to learn more about the region. It was ultimately guided toward Saturn for a scientific conclusion while sending vital data till the very end. Cassini performed 22 dives into Saturn's rings to establish their age. In 2019, scientists estimated the age of the planet they orbit to be between 10 and 100 million. Before Cassini's death, the mission of Voyager 1 to Titan assured a single outward course for decades. Her travels carried her outside the solar system. The ice giants Uranus and Neptune were the last two planets examined by Voyager 2. On March 13, 1781, William Herschel first observed Uranus. Although he first failed to recognize it as a new planet, it was the first of which the ancients were unaware. Over 200 years later, Voyager 2 came within 82,000 kilometers of Uranus's cloud tops. The eyes of Voyager revealed various astounding features of Uranus, such as very high jet streams racing over the planet's poles and equatorial zones, as well as a little more detail than we can see from Earth. The Voyager 2 spacecraft explored Uranus, a planet with a peculiarly oriented atmosphere. Its -224 degrees Celsius atmosphere makes it the coldest planet in our solar system. The tilt of Uranus's sideways position is around 98 degrees. A collision with an asteroid the size of Earth may have tipped Uranus over eons ago. Due to their great distance from the Sun, ice giants get between 100th and 1,000th of their light. Miranda is one of the most peculiar celestial bodies observed to date. Methane, which is more abundant in Uranus's atmosphere than in those of its bigger siblings, gives the planet its distinctive hue. Uranus, like other giant planets, has its own set of rings. The Kuiper Airborne Observatory, an airplane equipped with an infrared telescope, discovered the brightest Uranian rings a decade earlier. Additionally, Voyager 2 captured detailed images of the Moon. The 11th is the outcome of Voyager's observations. When the first snapshot of Miranda arrived, just where it should have been, it is a fractured, disassembled, and quickly reconstructed reality. The other half is a moon with characteristic craters found in orbit around other planets, while the other half is covered with deep furrows. Both are now present. They are incredibly different. However, they share a single body. There are cliffs more than 20 kilometers in height, and Miranda's gravity is so low that a person might stand atop one, stare straight down, and fall over the cliff. The descent will last around 20 minutes. Voyager 2 began its trek to its ultimate destination in August 1989. Neptune was discovered analytically as opposed to using a telescope. Due to its gravitational influence on Uranus, Neptune was discovered. Due to the light it radiates, the other planet's orbits would have been thrown out of alignment before humans saw it. At such a tremendous distance, communication with Voyager 2 would need technology advancements never seen. Like the Voyagers, probes are vigilant. The greater the significance of a thing, the farther it will go. To detect this, we will need to modify our receiving dishes. NASA created a network of three global communication complexes in outer space in 1986, enhancing our capacity to detect Neptune's faint radio emissions. Our responsibility is to instruct spacecraft so they know where to go, what to do, and what data to gather. Each deep space network complex has a 120-degree field of vision. At least one of the stations is always defective when a mission goes more than 30,000 kilometers from Earth. For complete coverage, NASA constructed the first station in the Mojave Desert of California, the second in Madrid, and the third in Canberra, Australia. The three primary telescopes were enlarged so that Voyager 2's 1987 rendezvous with Neptune could be heard more clearly. Eventually, it was published 2 years later. Engineers adjusted Voyager 2's course to examine Triton, the giant moon of Neptune. Voyager observed at least four icy and rocky rings. It also detected the stellar black spot, a violent planet-sized passing storm in the planet's southern hemisphere. Winds on Neptune are the fastest in the solar system, with gusts of around 2,000 kilometers per hour. A planet with a restricted atmosphere where geysers emit black soot rather than water ice. Like several of the inner moons of the other giant planets, the moon's surface exhibits black stripes caused by the moon's lower atmosphere and winds sweeping dark material across the surface. Before Voyager 2's flyby mission, scientists knew little about Uranus and Neptune. Before these expeditions, we believed the four gas giants to be the same. We learned that Uranus and Neptune are distinct from Saturn and Jupiter. We saw some of the coldest temperatures and highest wind speeds ever recorded on planets where the energy required for such dynamic systems is still a little hazy. Although we have been sending deep space probes for decades, we only know of these two planets due to Voyager 2's flyby. We must return a second probe and conduct more tests. Although humans may have compelling reasons to return, many unexplored locations exist in our solar system. It's time to learn more about these worlds we know so little about. The Voyagers would be the only ones to investigate the uncharted zone of minor rocky planets beyond the outermost planet of our solar system. A cluster of frozen bodies representing the earliest remnants of the solar system may exist 4.5 billion kilometers beyond Earth. The Kuiper Belt is the vast outermost area of our solar system where comets reside. Consequently, this area is rather peculiar. In 1930, Clyde Tombaugh, at 24 years old, developed it. The New Horizons spacecraft was designed to supplement Voyager's thorough solar system study. In 1992, despite its immensity, the Kuiper Belt was found. It contains the planet formerly known as Pluto. Pluto was reclassified as a dwarf planet in 2006 after discovering many Kuiper Belt objects of equal size. However, this has stayed the same since we continue to seek to uncover its mysteries. The New Horizons spacecraft may go beyond the Voyager's capabilities. They could not touch Pluto, the last conventional planet in our solar system. The probe was launched on January 19, 2006 from Cape Canaveral. 5 billion kilometers away, there were many unsolved questions about Pluto's creation, composition, and appearance. It took 15 months for all the collected data to reach Earth. More than 4 hours would be required to transmit and receive radio signals from the probe. The New Horizons download speed was 1 kilobit per second, 50 times slower than dial-up modems in the 1990s. Everyone awoke eager to get the newest photographs which had just arrived, been modified, and were being uploaded to the internet. It was astounding how much this meant to everyone who contributed to it. Nonetheless, it was of tremendous global significance. Before New Horizons, astronomers were unaware of the dwarf planet's size. Pluto, the biggest of the catalogued minor planets, was determined to have a diameter of 2,376 kilometers. However, the surface characteristics were remarkable. Glaciers and nitrogen ice flowed on its surface, creating valleys under 3 kilometer tall mountains, constructed from water, ice, and nitrogen snow. In some locations, the textures and patterns resemble works of art. It stunned us by showing a heart-shaped part. The terrain is smooth. It was unlike the old cratered surface that had been anticipated. A new moon's surface will develop within a million years. As New Horizons neared Pluto, it was discovered that the sky was naturally blue, like Earth's, due to nitrogen gas. As we left our solar system's planets behind and entered the interstellar void, the sun shone from behind Pluto, illuminating its blue atmosphere and the pitch blackness of deep space. Nevertheless, studies of the solar system's periphery leave us with more questions than answers. Several objects beyond Pluto have irregular orbits. Orbits may imply the existence of a gravitational pull that cannot be detected. Currently, another planet is known as Planet 9. Compared to other objects in the outer solar system, some asteroids or floating rocks slightly deviate from their intended path. There are 9 planets in the solar system. These orbits are well aligned in one direction, which is not a common occurrence by coincidence. They may be a giant planet that we have yet to discover. It must be essential for it to be there and have the desired impact. The existence of Planet 9 is supported by mathematical models and computer simulations, although it has yet to be detected. The distance between this object and Neptune is 20 times greater than that of Neptune, even though anything of Neptune's size would be massive. The planet's lights are solar reflections. If a 9th planet existed, it would be so far from the Sun that its light would be weak. The issue is that the Milky Way, the densest part of the sky, sits just above this object on Planet 9, in terms of the number of stars. How can you distinguish between the many background stars and the faint reflecting object that seems to be a planet in the night sky? It moves about these background stars, which seem immovable to our telescopes. We are searching for the appearance of a needle in a stack of hay. This explains why Planet 9 has yet to be found, if it even exists. The Voyagers are currently humanity's most advanced creations. Thus, they have provided us with the most remote idea of our house. February 14, 1990, it returned its cameras to the inner solar system for the last photograph, producing a panorama or family picture of the whole solar system. The Earth appears as a tiny light blue dot inside one of the sunbeams as seen from space. It caused everyone to contemplate the many universes and our role inside them. The first and second Voyagers have already reached the stars. When does the impact of the Sun cease? The limits of the solar system may be defined in several ways, and this is known as the heliosphere. Both Voyagers have departed our solar system and are now exploring the expanse of space. They have enough fuel to transmit communications till the middle of the 2020s. Something from the 1970s is still relevant today. Voyager is a spacecraft that records human space travel. Likewise, there is optimism for new discoveries. As we go farther into the unknown, the surprise findings cause us to exclaim, "Huh? I was not expecting to see that." Humanity responded to the distress signal from the most remote parts of space. The Voyager mission has drastically altered our perception of the outer solar system, revealing new planets that must be discovered. Our expeditions to the solar system's periphery have permitted almost 50 years of advancement. You felt a part of it very much. Each decade, your whole life, you discover a peculiar aspect of our solar system. It was motivating. Every robotic surveyor has increased the number of future missions that are achievable. If humans were to visit Enceladus in the future, our view of life in our solar system would be drastically transformed. These courageous explorers symbolize human exploration. We have reached a stage where the whole solar system and beyond can be habitable for humans. astronomers suspected the existence of Planet 9 in the early 20th century because it would explain the wobbles in Uranus and Neptune's orbits. When Pluto was found in 1930, astronomers felt it was the ghost planet they had been searching for. Nevertheless, the search was discontinued because it was believed that the gravitational pull of another planetary body was to blame. However, the search was restarted once it was discovered that Pluto was too tiny to crash with Neptune and Uranus. Poor Pluto would eventually be downgraded to a dwarf planet. Whether it is a planet at all is still fiercely contested. NASA said in 1989, based on data from Voyager 2's flyby of Neptune, that there were no anomalies in the outer planet's orbits and that they were not rogue. They were searching for something that did not currently exist. In 1992, the discovery of the Kuiper Belt gave more evidence that Planet 9 may exist. In this massive area of the solar system beyond Neptune, hundreds of thousands of frozen objects more prominent than 100 kilometers, 62 miles in diameter are projected, along with a trillion or more comets. Discovered between 2002 and 2005 and designated minor planets in 2006, Quaoar, Sedna and Eris are three of the odd objects here. Pluto is the most well-known of these objects. According to astronomers, Sedna has a long elliptical orbit that takes 11,000 years to complete. What attracts Sedna's attention? Could it be Planet 9, an enormous planet with a powerful gravitational pull? In 2016, Caltech's Mike Brown and Konstantin Batygin postulated the presence of a planet with a mass between 5 and 10 times that of Earth. This was afterward altered to 5 or 6 times the mass. This planet was thought to be tugging Sedna and 5 other objects tilted in the same direction and at the same degree. Since 2016, 19 unique orbiting objects have been detected. They rejected any planets similar to Neptune, leaving them with 11 that they felt could be impacted by their make-believe world's gravitational pull. Scientists imagined Planet 9's appearance based on estimates of its mass derived from its apparent gravitational pull intensity. Based on its mass and location in space, experts think it is either a super-Earth or a miniature Neptune. Since it shares characteristics with Uranus or Neptune, it is believed to be an ice planet with a solid core. Astronomers analyze groupings of objects, such as a certain kind of planet, instead of searching for a single object in the cosmos. Despite Professor Batygin's predictions, it will need considerable effort to determine Planet 9's orbit based on the velocity of the objects it is predicted to affect. Due to its obfuscated nature, it may be nearing the conclusion of its wide orbit, indicating that it is unlikely to reflect much sunlight. As a result, it will stay concealed among the stunning Milky Way starfield. Existing telescopes should still be able to see it. On Hawaii's dormant volcano, Mauna Kea, astronomers utilize the 8.2-meter Subaru telescope to help in the hunt for Planet 9. Subaru is only offered 3 nights each year, but it is now one of the most promising options for success. In its ongoing hunt for planets orbiting other stars, NASA's Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, TESS, may discover Planet 9, but the most significant enhancement is the construction of the Vera Rubin Observatory in Chile. Beginning in 2023, this 8.4-meter telescope will begin continually and routinely acquiring photos of 2/3 of the visible sky. As a result, astronomers can monitor the motions of celestial objects from the observatory atop the mountain while simultaneously looking for Planet 9. Planet 9 may be brighter and closer to Earth than previously believed, according to recent research conducted by Brown and Batygin. They now believe its orbit is far closer to the Sun than previously believed, taking just 7,400 years to complete instead of 18,500. This increases the likelihood of finding its existence. Planet 9 has adversaries. Some think that instead of a planet, there is a primordial black hole, one of the compacted masses formed in the first second of the universe's existence. The dumbest things in the universe are black holes. Consequently, they may influence the orbits of masses other than planets. Indeed, this is contemporary astronomy. Given the futility of Planet 9 searches, others contend that any presence indicators are only data ghosts. Others feel the appearance of Planet 9 in sky surveys results from a natural bias. They believe that it is dangerous to infer the presence of a planet from data collected near gravitational orbits, since we would need additional information about these objects to determine whether they were acting abnormally. Attitudes vary on Planet 9. Those committed to its discovery hope that one day we will finally be able to celebrate its finding. Skeptics believe this is an overly optimistic interpretation of the data, while black hole enthusiasts are more enthusiastic about the possibility of a primordial black hole than discovering a new planet. Skeptics on Planet 9 observe the unfolding events with dispassionate curiosity. Will Planet 9 always remain a mystery? Even though Brown has suggested this every year for the last 5 years, he feels it will be another year or two before we find our elusive co-traveler in the universe. Strange occurrences are occurring on the outskirts of our solar system. The only possible explanation is an object with a mass up to 10 times that of Earth, although it may be something else. Percival Lowell was motivated to discover the ninth planet in our solar system, a mythical planet X, that at the time was believed to be responsible for the errant orbits of the icy blue Uranus and Neptune. The pursuit of the phantom giant occupied the final decade of his life, culminating in several mental breakdowns and his death at 61. Despite being aware of his own mortality, Lowell gave $1 million to the search for Planet X in his will. After a little reprieve, he engaged in a legal dispute with his wife, Constance Lowell, while his observatory resumed its hunt. The universe was little. A student astronomer saw a speck on two images of a starry sky on February 18, 1930. He had discovered Pluto, previously believed to be the mysterious Planet X. In 2006, Pluto was demoted to dwarf planet status, making way for introducing a brand new ninth planet. To shift Neptune and Uranus from their familiar places, scientists immediately determined that this could not be what Lowell sought, since it required a greater force. Sadly, this was not the case. Pluto was only an unwelcome visitor who was present. In 1989, Planet X was annihilated when the Voyager 2 probe swept past Neptune and demonstrated that it was less massive than initially believed. Considering this, a NASA scientist determined that the outer planet's orbits were rationalized. Lowell had initiated an unnecessary search. Nevertheless, just as the notion of a personal planet was fading away, the framework for its revival was prepared. In 1992, two astronomers relentlessly combed the sky for faint objects beyond Neptune and discovered the Kuiper Belt. This cosmic donut of frozen particles extending just beyond Neptune's orbit is one of the most critical components of the solar system. It is anticipated to include up to a trillion comets and hundreds of thousands of objects more than 100 kilometers in diameter, 62 miles. Whether Pluto was a planet emerged when astronomers discovered it was unlikely to be the sole colossal object in the solar system's outer reaches. Astronomers immediately saw the need for a new definition. Then they detected Sedna, about 40% of Pluto's size, Quaoa, roughly 50% of Pluto's size, and Eris, almost the same size as Pluto. How is this possible, we questioned? This is just fascinating. According to Konstantin Batygin, the International Astronomical Union demoted Pluto and the newcomers to dwarf planet status in 2006. The ninth planet had disappeared. Mike Brown, a planetary astronomy professor at the California Institute of Technology, Caltech, is still known as the man who destroyed Pluto, because he led the team that discovered Eris. Additionally, finding these objects provides a significant new route for hunting a missing planet. Contrary to popular belief, Sedna is not moving through the Kuiper Belt in elliptical rings around the Sun. Instead, it follows an unusual and astonishing path, ranging from 76 Earth-Sun distances, or 11 billion kilometers, 7 billion miles, to more than 900, or 135 billion kilometers, 84 billion miles, from the center of our solar system. Sedna has the impression that she is being pulled away. In 2016, the same Mike Brown who had removed Pluto co-authored research proposing a planet 5 to 10 times the size of Earth. Konstantin Batygin, a professor of planetary science at Caltech, also contributed to the study. Six additional persons were attracted in the same manner. According to their calculations, there was a 0.007% chance that all six objects were moved in the same direction and tilted simultaneously. Other evidence includes that they are all tilted in the same direction on their axis. We thought, this is incredible. How is this possible? It was astonishing because the planet's gravitational force would lead such a gathering to disperse if left uncontrolled for long enough. Instead, scientists hypothesized that Planet 9's ghostly imprint had been left in the outer reaches of our solar system, causing its gravitational pull to alter the orbits of the objects in its vicinity. Although Planet 9 has never been observed, a surprising amount can be deduced. Its orbit, like that of other planets beyond the Kuiper Belt, would be so twisted that its most significant reach would be nearly 600 times the distance from the Sun to the Earth, 90 billion kilometers or 56 billion miles, compared to 300, 45 billion kilometers or 28 billion miles. There are now three primary hypotheses on Planet 9's probable beginnings. One hypothesis is that it developed where it currently resides, which Batygin deems doubtful, since it would need the early solar system to have extended as far as its remote refuge. Another intriguing option is that the ninth planet is an alien imposter taken from another star in the distant past, when the Sun was still in the stellar cluster in which it originated. However, according to Batygin, you're just as likely to lose the planet on your next meeting. Then there's Batygin's choice, which he admits is not a slam dunk, because it kind of stuck around the enormous planet formation zone before being stretched out by Jupiter or Saturn, and then having its orbit altered by passing stars. In this scenario, the planet originated when the solar system was first established, far closer to the Sun, and planets formed from the surrounding gas and dust. This raises the question, if Planet 9 exists, why has no one seen it? Until I began searching with Mike using telescopes, I had no clue how impossible it would be to identify Planet 9, adds Batygin. The search could be more problematic, since most astronomical surveys cover many topics. If you explore a vast enough space, you will find anything, even the unusual. Another exercise for astronomers is to locate a specific object, such as Planet 9. According to Batygin, the Subaru telescope is the only instrument capable of identifying Planet 9. This 8.2-meter behemoth atop Hawaii's Mauna Kea volcano can detect faint light from distant astronomical objects. This is advantageous because Planet 9 is so distant that it is unlikely to reflect much sunlight from the Sun. The good news is that the Vera Rubin telescope will be operational within the next few years, and they will almost certainly detect it, the expert said. This next-generation telescope, currently being constructed in Chile, will survey the sky by methodically scanning it and photographing the entire field of view every few nights. There is, however, a remote chance that the planet will never be discovered in this manner. It might be a black hole and not a planet. James Unwin, a physics professor at the University of Illinois at Chicago, and Jacob Schultz, a postdoctoral researcher at the University of Turin, were the first to propose the idea. Although we are most familiar with the notion that planets have enormous gravitational pulls, Unwin claims that there are other things that can cause it which are more unusual. According to Unwin, Planet 9 might be replaced by a tiny ball of extremely concentrated dark matter or an ancient black hole, since black holes are among the densest things in the universe and can disturb the orbits of distant planets. We're most familiar with two types of black holes: supermassive black holes, which are millions or billions of times more massive than our Sun, and stellar black holes, which are at least three times as massive as our Sun. While supermassive black holes are caused by dead stars collapsing in on themselves, stellar black holes are less well understood, and may have begun as massive stars that imploded before accumulating mass. Though they have never been observed, black holes are believed to have originated from the hot energy and matter cloud created in the first second after the Big Bang. In some areas of the universe, planets may have been squashed into small pockets due to the dense population. According to Unwin, a black hole can't have formed from one, since stars retain their immense gravitational pull and are concentrated. Because even the smallest stellar black holes have masses three times that of our Sun, it would be as if at least three other suns were pressing on the planets of our solar system. Because primordial black holes are significantly smaller, Unwin and Schultz believe there may be one of them. According to Schultz, these objects may have formed from minimally concentrated regions in the early universe. Is this really more thrilling than the discovery of a planet? What would it look like? Should we be concerned? Even the most superficial black holes are so dense that light cannot escape. They are the most accurate approximations of darkness. This implies that no modern telescope could detect it. The sole trace of its existence would be a giant hole in the night sky's blanket of stars. Like the projected Planet 9, this black hole would have a mass up to 10 times that of Earth, but it would be compressed into an area the size of an orange, making it challenging to locate. So far, options have included monitoring for gamma rays generated by items falling into black holes and sending a constellation of hundreds of small spacecraft that, with any hope, would pass near enough to be pulled ever so slightly towards it and accelerate by a measurable amount. Because the unknown gravitational pull originates in the most distant regions of our solar system, the probes would have to be launched using an Earth-based laser array that could accelerate them to 20% of the speed of light. If they went any slower, it would take hundreds of years for them to arrive, extending the experiment well beyond the lifespan of a human. These sophisticated spacecraft are now being created for the Breakthrough Starshot project, which seeks to deliver them to the Alpha Centauri star system, located 4.37 light-years away. According to Unwin, a supermassive black hole resides at the galaxy's center. While a primordial black hole would consume everything in its path, this would not include the Earth, which, along with the inner planets, never approaches close enough. Therefore, we do not need to worry about our solar system being consumed. According to Unwin, the existence of an undetected black hole in the solar system is analogous to the existence of a secret planet from the viewpoint of everyone on Earth. Schultz argues that circumstances involving little black holes are more intriguing than those involving enormous black holes. Even if her head and feet were just a few meters apart, the gravitational forces acting on them would be so different that she would be stretched like spaghetti. It's important to note that the effect should be much more pronounced as the black hole gets smaller. According to Schultz, it all comes down to relative distances. If you're 2 meters tall and passing through an event horizon from 1 meter from the center of a primordial black hole, the distance between your head and feet is more important than the black hole's size. This means you'll be stretched much further than if you fell into a star a million miles in diameter. The option that the long-sought-after ninth planet is a black hole, according to Batygin, is lovely, and we can't even begin to comprehend how it's put together. Planets are more plentiful, although that may be due to my personal bias as a professor of planetary science. Batygin, like Unwin and Schultz, is interested in a giant planet, noting that the most prevalent kind of massive planets in the galaxy are those with a mass comparable to Planet 9. According to him, the bulk of exoplanets that orbit Sun-like stars is between the sizes of Earth and Neptune and Uranus. The missing planet would provide the closest window into extrasolar life if discovered. Time will tell if the most recent search is more fruitful than Lowell's. Batygin is sure, however, that their purposes are essentially distinct. In terms of the facts it strives to explain and the methods it employs, each concept, in his opinion, varies greatly. The quest for the mythical ninth planet has transformed our understanding of the solar system. Who knows what else we will discover before the quest concludes? If Planet 9 exists, finding it may be less complicated and closer than previously believed. According to a new treasure map, a planet many times the size of Earth may be concealed inside our solar system behind the Milky Way's sparkling band of stars. One of the most exciting mysteries of our solar system is whether a gigantic ice planet exists deep beyond the orbit of Neptune. Since it was initially hypothesized, this hypothetical planet, dubbed Planet 9 by scientists searching for it, has aroused debate. The existence of the invisible planet is anticipated based on its apparent gravitational impact on a cluster of tiny particles whose orbits are arranged unusually. However, searches for it have yet to generate results, and skeptics say that any traces of its existence in the data are only ghosts. According to new research, if the mysterious planet exists, it may be closer, brighter, and more visible than previously believed. Astronomers think that the Earth spins around the Sun every 74,000 years as opposed to every 18,500 years. Planet 9 may seem brighter to Earth-based telescopes because it is closer to the Sun than previously believed. Mike Brown, an astronomer at the California Institute of Technology and one of the authors of new research submitted for publication in the Astronomical Journal, believes it will be detected within a year or two. He claims I am too optimistic, but I've stated the same for the last 5 years. The most current calculations of Planet 9's gravitational antics by Brown and his Caltech colleague Konstantin Batygin indicate that the planet is around 6 times the mass of Earth, indicating that it is either a rocky super-Earth or a gaseous mini-Neptune. If found, the planet would be the first significant addition to the solar system since the 1846 discovery of Neptune, an ice giant whose existence was predicted by its gravitational impact on Uranus. However, critics have maintained for a long time that Planet 9's gravitational signals are just coincidences. According to detractors, the apparent clustering of distant object orbits is the product of intrinsic biases in sky surveys, not an external effect. Most of these things are found using huge telescopes that have limited time for scans of the outer solar system, adds Renu Malhotra of the University of Arizona, who is doubtful of the planet's existence and working on her own estimations of its position. Astronomers have only detected a small number of these faraway objects. A more comprehensive survey of the outer solar system will make it simpler to determine whether these minuscule ice particles operate abnormally or are randomly distributed. Using their updated estimations, Brown and Batygin created a treasure map that directs searchers to the region of the sky where Planet 9 is most likely to be. This location is traversed by the bright, heavily populated plain of the Milky Way, which may have helped the planet evade previous searches. Brown says, "Now we genuinely know where to go and where not to go. Unless we made an error, this should resolve the problem." Although Brown and Batygin made their prediction of Planet 9 public in 2016, they are not the first to hypothesize the existence of an unknown planet in the solar system's outer regions. Astronomers have postulated about such a planet for over a century, incorrectly assuming that something significant was perturbing Neptune's orbit. Percival Lowell, the astronomer who coined the term Planet X, was so determined to locate it that, upon his death in 1916, he bequeathed $1 million to continue the hunt. Alternatively, Clyde Tombaugh of the Lowell Observatory discovered Pluto in 1930. The Caltech researchers determined the presence of Planet 9 based on its influence on Kuiper Belt objects, KBOs. A few tiny, icy planets beyond Neptune have orbits that take them at least 150 times farther from the Sun than the Earth's orbit. Batygin and Brown investigated six asteroids whose peculiar elongated orbital movements have long baffled astronomers. It was finished in 2016. Scientists found that an unseen planet 10 times the size of Earth was gravitationally guiding the objects along their Cuttawampus trajectories. According to studies of planets orbiting other stars, the planet's estimated mass places it between Earth and Neptune, making it a kind of planet that is common across the galaxy, but noticeably missing from our solar system. However, immediately after the revelation, scientists started questioning the Planet 9 theory. Their greatest fear was that the peculiar orbital clustering may not even be clustering. Different teams have concluded over the last 5 years that Planet 9's evidence is nothing more than an observational artifact based on multiple datasets. Planet 9 may be a ghost, and the apparent gravitational imprint it left is a fraud based on a multitude of erroneous data points. This recent research by Brown and Batygin is an effort by astronomers to resolve the problem, which they have not yet accomplished. The most recent estimates of Planet 9's size and orbit by Brown and Batygin were based on a slightly different collection of astronomical entities. The scientists added additional KBOs to their data collection, removed those whose orbits seemed to be impacted by Neptune's pull, and kept some original KBOs. They ultimately used 11 KBOs in their work. According to Brown, if you include the Neptune ones, your signal would get garbled, and you won't be able to tell what's happening. According to the most recent analysis, there is a 99.6% possibility that the odd orbital alignments of these objects are produced by an unknown planet and not by chance. That appears plausible, but Malhotra notes that the alignments had a 1 in 250 chance of being a fluke, which is far higher than the 1 in 10,000 probability reported by Brown and Batygin in 2016. Even though the current study is based on a limited sample size, Malhotra believes it is superior to earlier studies. She says, "It's fascinating enough that we should investigate it, but it's not plausible." In addition, Batygin undertook many simulations to predict how the Earth's properties, such as its position and mass, may influence these 11 orbits. The resultant treasure map goes to Planet 9's orbit, although the team is uncertain of the planet's probable location along this path. Even while its mass has reduced from 10 to around 5 or 6 times that of Earth, the planet is closer. This indicates that Planet 9 should seem more luminous in the sky. However, according to Brown, this estimate is based on inaccurate assumptions about the planet's composition. The new ideas match a similar claim by astronomers Chad Trujillo and Scott Shepard. When astronomers announced the discovery of the 2012 VP113 object in 2014, they playfully named it Biden in honor of the then Vice President of the United States, Joe Biden. They suggested that a planet 5 times the size of Earth might propel Biden and several other distant objects into congested trajectories. Despite the converging possibilities, the existence of Planet 9 must be agreed upon by field experts. Greg Loughlin, an astronomer at Yale University, asserts, "It stood up rather well for something that hasn't been discovered. The evidence is compelling, but I'm intrigued as to why and where they have yet to discover it." Scientists have yet to see Planet 9, which may indicate that if it exists, it is located in the furthest limits of its orbit, as a dim, slowly moving planet obscured by starlight. Even with the most sophisticated tools accessible to astronomers, the hunt remains difficult. Brown and Batygin seek the elusive planet utilizing the giant Subaru telescope on Hawaii's Mauna Kea. At its estimated brightness and orbit, Planet 9, a globe lost in our galaxy's milky streamer in the evening sky, dissolves into the brilliant masses of background stars. "That is virtually the only place where it could hide unnoticed," explains Loughlin. "Since the area is sufficiently bright, nearby, and noticeable, if it exists, it will be found quickly." Using Subaru to filter through star fields is one method astronomers may use to locate the planet in the sky. NASA's Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, TESS, continually searching for planets orbiting other stars may discover Planet 9 while scanning regions around the planet's probable orbit. The method being developed by Yale University's Loughlin and Milena Rice is predicted to enable the discovery of distant solar system objects using TESS photos in 2019. "I'm not optimistic about this," Loughlin adds. "But it's not inconceivable that TESS frames may reveal an object if it exists." Numerous experts believe that the Vera Rubin Observatory, currently being constructed on a Chilean mountaintop, has the best chance of locating Planet 9. With its enormous field of view, this 8.4-meter telescope will photograph the night sky every few nights. According to Malhotra, Vera Rubin will cover around two-thirds of the sky, but it will do so routinely and repeatedly, allowing us to make significant headway in addressing this issue. Brown believes the planet may be discovered before the pricey next-generation observatories become operational. He believes that the enigmatic universe is concealed in the data now collected by astronomers. According to Brown, "I'm willing to wager, and I frequently lose wagers, that there are already surveys with images of it." Brown discovered the minor planet Eris in 2005 at the Palomar Observatory, and he subsequently learned that the first image of it was on a photographic plate obtained by the same telescope in 1955. In the 1980s, a satellite telescope spotted Planet 9. The first infrared space telescope discovered a peculiar object beyond Uranus. In 1983, astronomer Michael Rowan Robinson used data from the infrared astronomical satellite, the first infrared space telescope, to search for a hypothetical 10th planet, Pluto was still considered a planet at the time. Rowan Robinson was confident that such a planet did not exist by 1991, at least not in the region of the sky he searched. Rowan Robinson must yet discover a new planet. The Kuiper Belt, a vast disk of comets, asteroids, and ice objects beyond Neptune's orbit, has encouraged some astronomers to hypothesize about the existence of a planet, or at least something with a lot of gravity. Rowan Robinson examined the 38-year-old data after recent research uncovered new potential hiding spots for Planet 9 and discovered three infrared sources that he believes represent the hypothesized planet. His study, already available on the preprint server at ArXiv, will be published in the monthly notices of the Royal Astronomical Society. Planet 9, previously known as Planet X, has long been considered a possibility. Neptune was found in 1846 after astronomers noticed Uranus's orbit slightly differed from what math predicted. The discovery of Pluto in 1930 did not account for Neptune's speed. Planet 9 is responsible for the unpredictable orbits of particular objects. According to experts searching for Planet 9, it has mass many times that of Earth, and an orbital period of millions of years. An alternative theory is that Planet 9 is merely a ring of debris. Some theorize that the planet may be a bowling ball-sized black hole. Rowan Robinson went to his previous search for his most current study and discovered three places in the data from late summer 1983 that suggested an object was moving through the sky. Rowan Robinson acknowledged in his study that the likelihood of the candidate being genuine is not overwhelmingly high, given the low quality of the IRAS detections at the extreme limit of the survey, and in a very difficult location in the sky for far infrared detections. We may soon receive new information. Every week, the world's giant digital camera will scan the sky at the newly constructed Vera Rubin Observatory in Chile.